Central Park, easily one of my favorite parts of New York. It is considered the lungs of the city. There is no way New York City could sustain itself without this 843-acre green space. It is full of all kinds of secret gems and hidden mysteries that we can't wait to show you. But where to begin? At the very beginning, long before the park's genesis. This is before Central Park. First and foremost, the oldest thing that can be found in the park, the bedrock. This is Manhattan schist, the incredibly dense rock that's found throughout the entire island of Manhattan that was created back when the supercontinent Pangaea was formed. This incredibly dense bedrock is what allowed us to build such tall buildings here in New York City. Yeah, it's a 335 million year old pile of schist. Some people take it for granted. And as much as these schist puns rock, I better stop or else I'll be basalted. I'm sorry, I know it's cheesy, it had to be done. Clean slate. Now, if you look closely at the schist, you can see the grooves that were carved into the rock some 10,000 years ago from a glacier that came down here from the Arctic. So, if you ever get lost in Central Park, find yourself some schist and you get your north-south axis. If you want to get out of the park, walk perpendicularly away from those lines. Central Park is only half a mile wide. It's 2.5 miles north-south. Now let's fast forward a few thousand years to when the indigenous people of North America once thrived here. What is now the New York area was once home to a number of Native American communities, and most unfortunately, these days it is very difficult to find traces of these communities, except for here, in the Ramble in Central Park, which is one of the oldest areas of the park, which still has old growth that may have been here before the park was constructed. And it's here within the Ramble that we can discover the Ramble Cave, also known as the Indian Cave. This natural cave was once used by the Native Americans that once lived here. It remained as a feature of the park. People could discover this by boat. You can see here where they used to tie their boats up. It remained in use until the early 1930s when far too much crime and at least one suicide was reported. It was then sealed up, and now this is all that remains. Now we fast forward again to the early 19th century. It's 1811 and the commissioner's plan has been approved. Now what we're talking about is Manhattan's gridded street plan. Long straight streets that are numbered instead of named. This was done so it'd be easier to navigate the city even if you didn't speak English. This was known as the Commissioner's Plan, the details of which are a story for another time, but beginning in 1811, the template for Manhattan's streets had to be laid out. Marble monuments would be placed where land existed, and iron bolts were installed into the bedrock. Now, almost all of these markers are gone, but some can still be found here in Central Park. This would be the exact location of 6th Avenue and 65th Street had Central Park never existed. This would have been the corner of 7th Avenue and 84th. Not long after the start of the Commissioner's Plan, war with England again. Known as the War of 1812, when England tried to take this all back, New York was inspired to build a number of fortifications in the Upper Manhattan area to protect our home. And by 1814, the blockhouse was constructed on this high vantage point, then known as Harlem Heights. The foundations of the blockhouse, it has been discovered, date back to the 18th century, when this land was still under British occupation. Volunteer construction workers brought some of their own supplies, so when you look closely, you can see that sandstone was used as well as schist. The War of 1812 never reached New York, but the blockhouse and other fortifications still remain. Which brings us to what was here immediately before the park's construction, Seneca Village. A community of around 300 founded by free black people, but also included Irish and German immigrants. This area spanned what would today be between 81st and 89th streets and 7th and 8th avenues. Schoolhouses, homes, churches, graveyards, all gone, destroyed to make space for the park. A very dark piece of history behind what is New York City's most important feature, Central Park, which was officially founded in 1858. Thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed it. Be sure to subscribe to catch our future episodes, and you can check out a previous episode here. See you real soon.